My name is FIda Qishta. I'm a Palestinian filmmaker from Gaza Strip. I raised and born in Rafah City in the south of Gaza. With my crew, we are making a film that tells the story of the people of Gaza. When I started filming, I told myself I have to film with people who can tell the story and can explain things. But when I reached Zaytun neighborhood where a Samuni family lives, one of the women introduced a child. Her name is Mona, 10 years old. She said to me, Mona lost both of her parents. And I said to myself, what a child gonna say? But Mona shocked me the way that she started to talk, and honestly how careless I was when I started filming with her. And she started to tell me the story and every single thing that the people of the family have been through. And that what made me think, as Palestinian, if I took the story from there, what people wanted to say, what people wanted to share, what people wanted you to know, that is the real film that we should make. The people of Gaza, they are normal. Normal people, they are not different from you. They didn't come from a different planet. They cry when they lose someone. They scream when they're scared. They laugh when they hear something funny. They look different? Maybe. I wear a scarf? Yes, it's part of my religion, but I feel. This film talking about the people themselves, what they have been through, how they take all of these things as normal or part of the life. It's not normal to lose your child or to see your uncle or your mother killed in front of your eyes. This is not normal. To see your house destroyed in front of your eyes and keep walking, as what happened with me and my family when our house destroyed. My father said one sentence, keep walking and don't look in your back. But dad, no way, keep walking. These memories shouldn't stay in your mind, even if it's painful. This is why you shouldn't keep it. Just keep walking. And this is what the people do. They keep going, no matter what happened around them. You might think this is crazy, but this is the way that they deal with things. This is the way that they get the hope from. How these people have hope, the way that they support each other. This is the story of the people who spent 50, 40 years of their lives don't know how the world looked like. I didn't know how the world looked like until I left Gaza in 2006. I saw how the other countries live. And I was asking myself why we should have all of this pain, why we should have all of this destruction. But at that time, I couldn't make anything. I didn't carry a camera, I didn't have money to buy a camera. But the first chance I got the camera was the first chance that I worked to get the stories out. And this is the real weapon that the people of Gaza use to make where should the birds fly happen and to make this dream, our dream, as Palestinian filmmakers, true. Please support this film generously as much as you can. And I know that you will. Your help is too important for us to show how much the people in the United States and the people in Europe care about the Palestinian cause and care about the normal stories that people wanted to tell them. Where Should the Birds Fly is a dream for us, but also will be true and real, and something can be touched with your support.